Good morning, children. Today you will learn about the eclipses. Okay. So here, eclipses, when it occurs, children, when any opaque object means which will not allow the light to pass through. Okay. And that time, in the path of the light, with this opaque objects comes in the path of the light, it blocks the light, and then it casts its shadow. Okay, that time only eclipse forms. Now see here, and not only that, that time the sun, earth and the moon, it should come, three of them should come in a straight line. Okay, and when it occurs, see, at times the earth comes between the sun and the moon, or the moon comes between the sun and the earth. In such a situation, the object in the middle, okay, the middle one, it casts its shadow on the another one. That is known as eclipse. Okay. Already I mentioned that there are two types of eclipses, lunar eclipse and solar eclipse. Right. Now see, lunar eclipse. Lunar eclipse, it actually occurs at night. Okay. It is the eclipse of the moon only. Okay. So here that always occurs on a full moon day, full moon night. Okay, so it is, see here, now when we see from earth, we can see on the sky this small spot. Can you see on the top? See that only small line, white line, you can see that. That means the whole area, it full became darkness, right? It means the it cast its shadow. See how it happens. When the earth, here see, you can see very clearly, sun, earth and the moon, three of them came in straight line. This here, the earth comes between the sun and the moon, right? That time it cast its shadow on the moon. That means who is coming in the middle? Already said eclipse comes that time when the opaque object comes in the middle one, right? That middle one, that cast its shadow on another one. So here earth came in the middle, it means it cast its shadow on moon. Okay, that is the lunar eclipse. This time the earth blocks the sunlight, sunlight coming from here, right? This one is blocked by the earth to from reaching to the moon. Okay, as a result, what happens? The moon gets hidden from the view. That means the people from the earth, those who looking at the moon, they can't see. Understood? That really mentioned. And the lunar eclipse, it may be partial as well as complete. Okay, total. Okay, total lunar eclipse as well as partial lunar eclipse. When the moon is completely in the dark shadow. See here, you can see the dark shadow, right? Gray color, full dark, right? This much area. See, from here to here. That is actually that shadow, it has two parts. Okay, shadow has two parts. One is the umbra and the another one is the penumbra. Okay, so when it is, see here, the part of the shadow that totally blocks the light, that is the umbra, and here it is partially. Partially means some areas it will be visible. So partially it is light gray, right? So those areas, that is known as the penumbra. Clear? And now see, total lunar eclipse, when it happens, when the moon is completely in the dark shadow of the earth, from here to here, see, that is the total lunar eclipse. And when the moon is partially hidden by the dark shadow of the earth, it is the partial eclipse. Okay, partial areas, that way. Understood? This one, lunar eclipse. Now see how it is happening. Earth coming in between, right? So earth casts its shadow, so that in different places, see, some of the areas it will be visible and some of the area totally shadow forms. Okay, and the next one is the solar eclipse. This solar eclipse, it occurs during the daytime, and not only that, it always occurs on the new moon day. Okay, new moon day means Amavasya. And lunar eclipse, Purnima, Purnima day, that means the full moon day only it occurs. Clear? Understood? Now see here, the solar eclipse during the daytime, if you are looking at the sky, you can visible this portion, top portion you see near the heading. Outside it is orange in color, right? That means the light, it is the rays of the sunlight only. But this portion, this dark black portion, it is actually the shadow. It is shadow of the moon only. Okay. Now see, this is occurs in the new moon day. And here also, you know, this umbra means the complete shadow. Okay. That means the part of the shadow that blocks the light completely. That is the umbra. And these areas, that is the penumbra. Clear? And now see how it happens. Where here moon is coming in between, right? So see, when the moon comes between the sun and the earth, that time it blocks. So who is in the middle? Now moon is in the middle. So moon will block the light, right? It casts its shadow on earth. Okay? So it blocks the sunlight, this moon blocks the sunlight from reaching to the earth. Okay, from the sun to earth, it will not allow the light to reach. That means it casts its shadow on the earth. So people from the earth, those who are looking at the sun, they are not able to see. If it see also in this way only it comes. Okay, and anyhow it is saying that, advising that during the solar eclipse, do not look directly to the sun, because it will not be complete darkness. Light slightly, there will be a cloudy day, like that it will be visible. And if it is there on the bright light also, should not look at the sun directly, because harmful radiations will come from the sun during this eclipse time. Even in the lunar eclipse also, that's what the people advised, that during those eclipse time, do not eat anything. Why? Because during this eclipse time, one is casting its shadow on another. So that time it emits so much harmful radiations. Okay. That actually it will be harmful to us. If we eat the food, then these rays will reach on the earth also. It will be in the atmosphere. So if the if we are eating the food, then it will harm to us. That's what advising. Don't eat during that time. Okay. And see here, when this solar eclipse, how it is the partial, and here also you can see the partial solar eclipse as well as the total solar eclipse. Now see the total solar eclipse, how it is happening. When the sun cannot be seen at all. Okay. If we are looking from here, right? This area full, it is moon casting its shadow. So from earth, this area, if we are looking, we cannot see the sun. Okay. Then that is known as, if totally if we can't see, then that is total solar eclipse. And if partially, if we are able to see, then it is the partial solar eclipse. Okay. The region on the earth where the umbra falls. See this is the earth, right? Where the umbra falls. Understood? That has a total solar eclipse, and the region where the penumbra falls, that area has the partial solar eclipse. Okay, and this solar eclipse, anyhow, during the daytime only, it will not, that means the duration will not be more, because it is then we, if the full area become darkness, then there will be no day and night recognition, right? So the solar eclipse, it lasts only for very short duration. That means few minutes only it will be there. More than 1 or 2 minutes, more than that it will not be there. Understood this one? This only that solar eclipse. Now see here, you can see very clearly in both, only one diagram shown here, but in that here only both the eclipses explained. But you see here, sun and earth coming, right? And here coming in between, who is coming? That is moon. Okay, that is also be which time? New moon day it comes. And us, if the moon comes in between the sun and the earth, then which eclipse forms? That is solar eclipse. And here you see, if the sun, from here sun to moon, in between who is coming? Earth is coming. That also be in the night. Okay, and in the full moon day. So if the earth comes between the sun and the moon, then which solar eclipse forms? That is the lunar eclipse. Understood all of you? Okay, thank you children. Have a nice day.